10 Most Dangerous Science Experiments Ever Conducted. Science is a force for good in our world. And science helped us have a better and more convenient life in many ways. But it is also a very powerful tool that can become dangerous in some situations, especially when it gets entangled in politics and wars. At other times, science's inherent ambition to push boundaries of what is known can also lead to some heart-stopping moments. In this video, you will see some of the most horrific scientific experiments that happened in history. Of course, we did not count all the experiments, but after watching this video, you will be able to know how far the experiments can reach. Project MKUltra. The legendary attempt of CIA to master mind control is known as the Project MKUltra. The program started in the 1950s and lasted seemingly until 1966. Under MKUltra, often unwilling subjects were given drugs, especially hallucinogenics like LSD. The people tested were also put through sleep and sensory deprivation, hypnosis, sexual abuse, and other kinds of psychological torture, while some tests proved lethal. The supposed goal of the project was some combination of chemical weapons research and effort to create mind-controlling drugs to combat the Soviets. Weaponizing the plague. Plague is one of the most deadly epidemics in humans, which caused the deaths of millions. The last time plague roamed around, it killed around half of Europe's population, reducing the amount of people in the world by nearly 100 million during the 13th and 14th century. In the year 1980s, it was discovered in the research program about biological warfare of Soviet Union the way on using plague as a weapon by launching it in the missile warheads to enemies. Besides the plague, defectors revealed that the Soviet bioweapons program also had hundreds of tons of anthrax and tons of smallpox. Kola Super Deep Borehole. A Soviet experiment, started in 1970, sought to drill as deeply as possible into the crust of the planet. By 1994, they bore a 12 km deep hole into the Kola Peninsula in Russia's far northwest. The record dig provided much scientific data, like the finding of ancient microscopic plankton fossils from 24 species. Nothing contradictory happened, but concerns occurred about the abrupt production of seismic effects because of too much drilling or perhaps cracking the whole planet Earth open. As of today, the whole site from this experiment is closed. Guatemalan STD Study. This horrid experiment is another instance of the US government causing harm in the pursuit of science. From 1945 until 1956, around 1,500 Guatemalans were deliberately infected with sexually transmitted diseases, including syphilis and gonorrhea. The subjects included orphans, prisoners, prostitutes, and military conscripts. Researchers used unscrupulous techniques, infected prostitutes and injections to infect their subjects and accomplish their experiment. Subjects of the experiment are currently suing Johns Hopkins University for $1 billion for its role in the study. The Tuskegee Syphilis Experiment. A government-funded study from 1932 to 1972 denied treatment for syphilis to 399 African-American patients in rural Alabama, even as penicillin was found to be effective against the disease in 1947. The patients were actually not told they had syphilis, with doctors blaming their bad blood instead and given placebos. The U.S. Public Health Service conducted this experiment to study and discover the natural progress and effects of syphilis is left untreated. A number of 100 patients died due to related complications, while 28 patients directly died from syphilis. The Aversion Project. The Aversion Project was a medical torture program in South Africa led by Dr. Aubrey Levin during apartheid. The project identified gay soldiers as conscripts who used drugs in the South African Defense Forces. A medical torture program was instituted in South Africa between 1971 and 1989 to cure homosexuality in military conscripts. The policy, carried out under apartheid, included forced aversion therapy treatments like electric shock therapy and chemical castration. The army also authorized as many as 900 sex change operations. It was widely believed in the medical community at the time that homosexuality was a mental illness that could be cured. Dr. Aubrey Levin, in charge of the program as chief psychiatrist of the South African military, was eventually accused of human rights abuse by international organizations and received a prison sentence. Nazi concentration camp experiments. Nazis carried out medical experiments on thousands of prisoners in concentration camps, without any regard for human life. Some of their research involved purposefully inducing hypothermia, infecting people with malaria, using mustard gas on people, forced sterilization, giving prisoners different poisons, infecting wounds with bacteria and filling them with wood shavings and ground glass. The quintessential evil doctor named Joseph Mengele is the Nazi doctor to be blamed for such experiments. He gave particular attention and focus on twins, which are mostly Roma, Gypsy, and Jewish. Mengele, also known as the Angel of Death, was accountable for abominations such as removing people's organs without anesthesia, dismemberment, and injecting prisoners with lethal bacteria and others. Not surprisingly known as the Angel of Death, Mengele collected the eyes of murdered victims for heterochromia research and attempted to prove through experiments the supposed resistance of Jews and Roma to a host of diseases. Circa 1940, Joseph Mengele, before he became known as the Doctor of Auschwitz and the Angel of Death for his pseudoscientific experiments on inmates in Nazi death camps. Unit 731. Unit 731 was a secretive R&D unit of the Japanese Army that carried out horrendous experiments on humans during World War II. Commanded by General Shiro Ishii, the unit experimented on an estimated 250,000 men, women, and children. Most of the victims were Chinese, along with some prisoners of war from Russia and the Allies. Forced surgical operations include vivisections, the practice of cutting and operating live subjects without anesthesia, amputations of limbs, and the removal of internal organs such as liver, lungs, brain, etc. The subjects were subjected to forced pregnancies, biological warfare, frostbite testing, and weapon testing using flamethrowers and grenades. It is considered a black point in the history of Japan to this day. The Trinity Test. It's hard not to put the world's first nuclear test on such a list. In the mad rush to develop the atomic bomb and gain a military advantage in World War II, America instituted the secretive Manhattan Project. This resulted in the Trinity Test, a detonation of the first ever nuclear weapon in a New Mexico desert on July 16, 1945. Even though most scientists are certain of the work they have done, there were still influential doubters who questioned the bomb's capability. Some even wondered if the bomb would cause total destruction of living and non-living organisms on Earth. Waiting for the bomb to go off, Nobel Prize-winning physicist Enrico Fermi wagered others whether the bomb would just destroy New Mexico or the world, potentially setting the Earth's atmosphere ablaze. Watson's Little Albert Experiment. In 1920, John Watson, along with graduate student Rosalie Rayner, conducted an emotional conditioning experiment on a 9-month-old baby whom they nicknamed Albert B. at Johns Hopkins University in an effort to prove their theory that we're all born as blank slates that can be shaped. The child's mother, a wet nurse who worked at the hospital, was paid $1 for allowing her son to take part. The Little Albert experiment went like this: researchers first introduced the baby to a small, furry white rat, of which he initially had no fear. According to reports, he didn't really show much interest at all. Then they reintroduced him to the rat while a loud sound rang out. Over and over, Albert was exposed to the rat and startling noises until he became frightened any time he saw any small, furry animal, rats, for sure, but also dogs and monkeys, regardless of noise. Who exactly Albert was remained unknown until 2010, when his identity was revealed to be Douglas Merritt. Merritt, it turns out, wasn't a healthy subject. He showed signs of behavioral and neurological impairment, never learned to talk or walk, and only lived to age 6, dying from hydrocephalus, water on the brain. He also suffered from a bacterial meningitis infection he may have acquired accidentally during treatments for his hydrocephalus, or, as some theorize, may have been horrifyingly intentionally infected as part of another experiment. In the end, Merritt was never deconditioned, and because he died at such a young age, no one knows if he continued to fear small furry things post-experiment. This was our list of 10 most dangerous science experiments ever conducted. Tell me in the comments, what do you think is the most dangerous experiment? Thank you for watching, and I hope you liked the video. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel to receive all new.